commercial flooding didn't work.
Operation Wet Tiger.
Blowing up the temple's elephant mouth should turn this grotto into a swimming pool. I'll cover Murray from the chopper's gun turret while he pries the mouth open. Once that's done, Sly will need to walk the Cherry Bomb 500 into the throat. Then get to high ground as fast as you can. Rajan is sure to show up and be extra angry.
Seems happy in that picture.
Snag his half of the clockwork heart, and we're out of here.
Alright, so it is time for the heist for episode 3. And, of course, once we finish that, we'll move on to episode 4. But let's not get carried away. I'm wondering how we start the heist, with which character? Murray, okay, that's a change. I don't think we've started a heist with Murray yet. So that we will do. It's right over there, but as we all know, it's going to take a lot longer to get to a destination with Murray because, well, he has to go the long way. He's not very good at taking shortcuts. So let's try to find the fastest way. I think we have to go all the way around here and then up on the right side. You know what, Flashlight Guard? You are going to be taken out. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. Get me a few coins, and there we go. Alright, let's not get seen by this elephant with spotlights. And start Operation Wet Tiger up.
Let's head out for the turret, Murray. Alright, I'll set up shop here and provide covering fire while you try to pry open the elephant's mouth for Sly.
Check.
Okay, I guess the downed helicopter on top of the tower is the turret we're using. I think we have to go over to the door or whatever and open it so that Sly can blow it sky high with the Cherry Bomb 500.
Clear out those guards before you take a crack at them.
Alright, we've got to take these guys out, these frickin' monkeys. And, wow, okay. I'm gonna body slam the hell out of you. There we go. Okay, are you just gonna keep coming, seriously? Alright, there we go. Does Rajan know everything? Come on, okay. Now we've got to... Wow, okay. You're dropping bombs on Murray, on the hippo just to stop him from opening that? Where does Rajan get ideas like this? This part isn't that hard. I mean, I think it says helicopter health right there, so I think if these things come down, then they're going to destroy the helicopter? I thought we were supposed to be protecting Murray, not ourselves, but oh well. Alright, sooner or later. Yeah, I'm up to the point where I can see them spawning now, I'm so high. Okay. These are some weird looking bombs. It's dropping a whole hell of a lot of them, though. Alright, just keep tapping this trigger. Sooner or later, all these go away, hopefully, please. There we go. Is that it? No more. Yay, just what I wanted. We have to be getting to the end, sooner or later. Alright, this is the last one. Yep. Alright, so... Okay, you were working on it the whole time, and now you can do it in like 5 seconds, really?
Yes! The Murray's might and muscle triumphs again!
Yeah, sure, Murray, okay, just keep talking while I... Okay, now we have to make it all the way over there with Sly. It's not that far away, but there's probably going to be a few... annoying flashlight guards, or regular guards, along the way. Oh, there's Murray right up there. If we got hit right now, we would be completely... Yeah, well, basically, to put it nicely, we'd blow up. The weird thing is, during the cutscene, when it does blow up, it looks nothing... It doesn't look any different. It looks like a normal TNT barrel. I mean, it doesn't make a bigger explosion or anything. Yeah, you keep on walking, buddy. You just keep on walking. You didn't just see that random TNT barrel, like, laying against the wall, did you? Yeah, don't worry about it. Just keep walking. Completely ignore the obvious danger. Alright, so now we gotta walk it over to this door. I love how this one door is holding the entire dam water. I don't think so. But once we jump out, we got some slow motion, and there we go, yeah. I mean, it didn't look like that big of an explosion. And I have no idea how Sly and Murray made it out of there, but they do. Yep, there he comes. He didn't even have to open the door. He just walked right through it. That's how much of a boss he is.
Black clouds and thunderbolts, my spice temple, ruined! I will no longer hide while you villains destroy my hard-won empire. This place is mine. Here I am king. Come, face me, Cooper. With Clockwork's black heart, I will show you true power. You are nothing. Come face the might of Rajan, lord of these hills.
All right, are you done yet, or can we fight?
We really do the job.
Yes, you do seem to have quite a talent for it.
Constable Neela, slumming it with the...
I like how Murray doesn't notice anything that's going on right now.
He should be brought to justice.
Like, he doesn't notice that Sly, a criminal, is talking to Neela, a cop.
Just try to keep up.
Or maybe he's just so dumb he doesn't really notice. He might not even know who Neela is, but... I swear, I think he's seen her before, but oh well. We've got to follow Neela now. I guess she's helping us during the boss battle. So, this is just... I think there's two parts to the boss battle. But you see, whichever way he puts his staff, if he puts it on the left, the middle, or the right, that's where he's going to do it. Right now he's in the middle. And now on the right. And we've already made it here.
Neela, now.
So, easy stuff.
Sorry. What are you doing?
Yeah, and... Neela sort of betrays us right here, and basically she's a bitch, so Sly is knocked out over there.
This is the gang I've heard so much about and feared these long hours. The Murray will renew your fear.
Who's the Murray? All I see is a fat, pathetic weakling.
I might be big and not as smart as the other guys, but one thing I'm not... is weak.
I like how your tooth is going through your lip right there, Murray. That looks really cool. Alright, so during this fight, he's just gonna swing his little clockwork heart around. We're going to dodge that, hopefully. And then once we push him in the electricity, he'll like do that shock move on the ground. And basically that's what you do. You try to work him like over to the electricity. Get out of here, into that electricity. Alright, I've got to get on a lily pad. And sooner or later, he's going to start sending guards in. But the good thing is, you can really tell he like cares about his guards because he'll kill them. And every now and then he'll hit them with his little staff. And I just got electrocuted there. They do drop health though, so that's really helpful because... this boss fight can be kind of annoying, especially you just have to be, you know, patient. Otherwise, you're gonna get hit in the face with his clockwork staff. Alright, I was trying to push him into the electricity. It doesn't quite work most of the time.
Fat, pathetic, weakly.
And if we lose, he shakes his head and calls us fat and pathetic and all those lovely names we all love to be called. And we have to start over, so it seems like I can only push him about once and then he'll swing his staff, and after that I can't really affect him anymore. So it's kind of like push him back, and then keep dodging. I guess we'll have to do that. Sometimes he'll like change directions like that, so you're like getting further away from the electric fence, so you kind of have to Oh, is there some health over here? Let me get this health. Stay on the lily pad. Kill your guard. That's awesome. Just keep that up. Alright. There we go. We've already hurt him about one third of the way, and we didn't even get him on the electric fence once until then. I've never really tried using power-ups during the fight. I mean, I'm not sure if they would even help. Like, I don't think fire fists or whatever do, like, much more damage than... I don't think they do any more damage than normal punches, because I guess Rajan is flame-resistant. Let's get this health. Let him kill some more guards. And we're now... Now his health's halfway down. This is a pretty long boss fight. I'm not sure if it's the hardest in the game or not. I actually cannot really remember what I would call the hardest boss fight in the game. There's none really that are, like, you know, super frustrating or anything. But... I don't know. They all kind of seem the same. Well, not really the same, you know what I mean, like, the level of difficulty. I just know the final boss fight on the first game is really annoying. The final boss fight on this game, it can be kind of the same. I mean, it does make sense to have the final boss fight to be annoying, but, because it should be the hardest one, but, you know. Seems every now and then you'll get that one boss that's like, why are you so hard? You're like the second boss we fought, but... Alright, he's almost done. I think we're gonna get him before we get him into the electric fence again. Or maybe we can end the fight on the electric fence, that'd be kinda cool. But there we go. Slow motion. Get on the ground. I'm gonna body slam you. Dang it, I was in midair.
Sly's gonna want this half of the clockwork heart safe and sound.
Oh yeah, you hold that clockwork heart up in the air, buddy. Oh great, there's the bitch again.
What? Neela? Throw down a ladder. Sly's hurt real bad.
What? Okay, I guess Murray didn't notice that she was the reason for Sly being hurt.
There they are, Contessa. Just as I promised. The Cooper gang and Rajan all incapacitated.
Excellent police work, Constable Neela. Carmelita's never been able to catch the Cooper gang. Yet you capture them in just a few short weeks.
Well, I never...
Really, Carmelita. Accept your defeat gracefully.
Actually, Contessa, there's a good reason Inspector Fox never caught the Cooper gang. She's been in league with them the whole time. Liar! Prove it! This is a photo of
Neela's been the one in with her, in with us the whole time. But she kind of backstabbed Carmelita. And us, and basically everybody.
Men, place Inspector Fox under arrest.
I'll get you, Neela. Don't think I won't.
Such a pity when an officer falls from the light.
Yes, indeed.
But you missed one. Bentley did not get caught.
Double crossing, cockney liar.
And yes, the heist is finished, but a third of our crew is captured. 2/3 of our crew is captured.